Pursuant to mechanical code, what is the maximum length a flexible connector can be ran for?
For ductwork? I have no idea.
25 feet.
Learn something new every day. Oh, look, it's our favorite friend Rocco from RSM Custom Home Buildings, the Five Towns premier ultra luxury home builder. Hi, Rocco.
Hello, Mike.
Are we doing a cathedral ceiling in this master bath?
No.
No. Yeah, look, notching and drilling according to code. Very nice. That was existing.
We have notching and drilling.
Right there, bottom, look.
Huh?
Look, the 3-inch.
That was there.
I know, it's existing. I know. Damn. What kind of ceiling are you putting in here?
Flat.
Flat?
Yeah,
flat. Skylight sand?
What? We're doing flat.
Very nice. Okay, so I'll put that's exactly what I'm going to do.
Perfect. All right, guys. Let me give you a little status update. It is Thursday, July 24th, 2025. It is about 8 minutes to 11 here in the great state of New York. Just about done with this 3-ton HVAC system, dual fuel. We have a fan coil off the boiler. And we have the heat pump condensing unit outside. This is day 2, and we're just about done. We had a half day last week on Friday from around 7:30 to around 12, and this morning again from 7:30 to probably around 12, we'll be all cleaned up, tools in the truck, and job is complete. And that is installing a 3-ton heat pump system, all new ductwork, 2 returns, line set, the works. The only thing that we did keep is 3 runs to the existing master bedroom. We extended them because they were a little short on the flex, 7-inch flex. And yeah, everything else is new. So let me show you what we did today. And let me get your thoughts and feedback in the criticism section down below. Let's go.
Contractor built this temporary stairs so the trades can access the construction site. This is the study. We have an 8-inch there. The return was there. I put it here. So that way when you come out of the master bedroom itself, you have this long corridor. That's abandoned. This is abandoned. You have this long corridor. You have a storage room with 1 duct. That's staying, by the way. We have the master suite with 1. Our return is here. There's that study. This is the master closet. We have 1 there. Let's go into the other side. This is the gym. The gym is only accessible from the hallway that's blocked off through the sitting room here. So I have a 10-inch return right there going to our air handler, an 8-inch. This bathroom has a duct. This is the sitting room. 2 more ducts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 14 by 30 off of 14. And a 10 by 10 off a 10 for the return over there. 2 returns, looking pretty good. Derek, how was your day today?
Spectacular.
Spectacular. Spectacular. Derek, how did you like Pearsall Station for lunch on Tuesday? Was it nice? Fire, right? You got the lunch all the time now.
Best part of work, don't eat lunch.
That's right. We eat well, folks. I gotta admit, man, this is a huge closet. Look at this. There's the entry into the closet, double doors. And then you have this huge closet. I think it's just for the wife. I think this is gonna be the husband's closet. My wife would die to have a giant bedroom for a closet, that's for sure. Let me take you up to upstairs before I do that. Our existing heat loops, 3/4-inch PEX B. This is the crimp PEX. Vapor barrier.
Let's see, I didn't look for vapor barrier. Yeah, there it is. Got the oxygen barrier there. Vapor barrier, oxygen barrier. That's going up here. I'm running 3/4 inch L tubing across. We've got the strut there with the unistrut clamps. We go across here to there, across, and Daniel's right now pressing in the fittings going into the hydro coil. Let me show you what that is upstairs. There it is. Plenty of room here to work. Really looks really, really nice. We got some split ring hangers there to have nice pitch on our drain. Once Daniel moves that supplyhouse.com box out of the way, you'll be able to see the split ring hangers. Ah, there's one right there. Look at that. Fire! The other drain, the emergency drain, piped in to the pan, and that goes also outside. We're gonna bring those right outside. Looking great. Looking really, really, really great. And folks, I know, Mikey Pipes, why the homeowner has this big giant closet, a lot of this space, why is he putting the air handler in the attic? Folks, you know, we're the great state of New York, the great communist state of New York for a reason, because we do things half backwards here. We do, it makes no sense that the air handler is in the attic, but in New York, you're gonna find air handlers in basements, very rarely, and in attics. It's not Florida, it's not down south where you're gonna find it in the garage or find it in a second floor closet or find it in a closet in the house. Nope, you're gonna find it in the attic. And after all my tenure in the great state of Florida, I only went into one air handler where the air handler was in the attic, but it was a spray foam attic. And it was a really, really, really nice attic. It was a beautiful attic, it was a sexy attic. That struts there. All I have to do now is connect it to the PEX here and we are done. Too bad the electrician didn't run power the way he's supposed to. But for all those who say, Mikey Pipes, the condensers are in front of the disconnect panels, let me show you what you're missing. See? Thought I was BSing you guys, huh? This is what the contractor did, by the way. Who am I to question, okay? 3-ton, 4-ton. Beautiful. The people are hungry. So we decided to clip this around a little bit. I was gonna have the drain go onto the slab here, but we decided not to because this slab is not part of the structure of the home. This was an add-on for the generator for elevation purposes. So the one closest to the right wall is the emergency drain. We're gonna have that go out past the gutter. The one further away, the one to the right is the emergency?
Yeah.
Oh, that's dumb.
Why is that dumb?
How are you going to get that over the gutter?
What do you mean by how?
The emergency has to go over the lip of the gutter.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, no problem. Do you. You don't know what I'm trying to say, do you? Okay, there you go. See? So now, that one goes into the gutter. And the other one is gonna hang over the gutter.
Yeah.
Tits! Dan, you like tits?
Yep.
You know, Derek likes them.
Yep.
I'm not sure about Daniel. But you see his girlfriend before?
Yeah,
so that's the primary drain.
Correct.
Okay. I'll just bring it out like a couple inches, maybe 2 inches. Derek, you gotta get a 90. 1 3/4 PVC 90. You're not going to glue on that 90.
Okay. Yeah, so they can do the gutter.
Yes.
Want me to
grab that for you or?
No, I need it today.
Okay. His hand's a little occupied right now.
Perfect. So now that will drip into the gutter, and the other one will hang over the gutter, and we'll let the homeowner know that when that drips, you better, is there a float switch too on there, right?
Yes.
So there's a float switch on the primary, and there's an emergency drain coming from the emergency drain pan.
And there's a wet switch in the emergency.
And it is a wet, you know what? All else has to fail. Because you know,
look, Derek's flossing. We're taking some selfies.
For Snapchat.
What's your girlfriend's name, Derek?
Oh, he's here. My ex-girlfriend.
Oh, is it ex-girlfriend now?
I'm single.
You're single. Fellas. I'm sorry, fellas. Ladies. Derek is single. He's 19 years old. He's got a good job. First year apprentice to HVAC technician. Hustling. Dependable like all El Salvadorians. They show up on time every single day and they hustle. Hondurans are a totally different other animal, by the way.
They're crazy.
They are crazy, right? I knew it.
Like the
Dominicans. You said it, not me. All right. So, folks, that's all she wrote, folks. 11:34. The job is complete. Now, granted, we can't commission the system because the contractor electrician is an idiot, or I don't know, maybe, let me take that back. The contractor's electrician did do the two disconnects the way they needed to be done, right? But he never ran power to our air handler. So now we can't start up and commission the system, but it's ready to go. The system has been charged. We dumped the refrigerant from the system last week when we were here on Friday. All we need now is power to the air handler, plug in the disconnect. Hopefully the disconnect's not plugged in. Let's see. And then I touch it and I go bzzz. Oh no, it's off, okay. Nice, beautiful Mikey Pipes by ACiQ. Oh, look how effed up my thing is. It all got scratched up already. Damn construction contractors. Ah! We're back. So we're gonna start with the coil. Remember what the pressure was yesterday?
510.
Okay.
And it was 80 degrees outside.
Here we go, 510, 80 degrees. It's actually 80 degrees again right now. It'll lose a little bit though.
Well, that's right in the core depressor.
Oh, smart. Wow.
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 Substantial.
That is a lot of pressure. Okay, let's go check everything else. Damn. And I didn't pick it up and you didn't pick it up.
No.
Wow, okay, let's just check outside. Now the $1 million question is, how fast is Bosch gonna furnish a replacement coil? Because my clients don't like to wait, especially when you have this kind of investment in your house. Woo! What was this one at?
Imagine both, 510. Same pressure for both.
Oh, then, nah. You have the line set and condenser separate?
I have the condenser isolated.
Oh, okay. And what was this at yesterday?
5:12.
Okay.
There you go. Yeah. Line set is good.
Nice. That's a good thing.
That is a great thing.
Corey. In our system, at least as an evaporator assembly.
Correct. So, all right, where is it?
Let's see. Do we have... We do not. We don't stock that anywhere.
Amazing.
That would be something that would have to come through Bosch's system. We don't stock that.
Yeah, that sucks. Okay.
Have you spoken with the reps at all if Bosch actually has it in stock or not?
I spoke to Platsky, and it's back ordered until the end of August.
Yeah, that's where we would go because they're the reps for it.
Yeah. So do you have any 5-ton Bosch IDS air handlers in 410A left?
That we would have, no.
You sure?
We're pretty well out for that for Bosch anyway. We may in GE or Samsung or anything.
No, like that, I need a Bosch IDS 2.1 or 2.0 air handler in 410A.
Really, the only folks might be MCN or SIDS, but that would be it. I know the Ferguson folks don't carry it. We don't. Renort doesn't.
We have the new stuff, right?
It would really be. Not for Bosch.
You don't carry Bosch anymore?
We very little, pretty much as request. But a lot of that 20-series stuff where we carry the GE version of it.
Huh. Okay, because I probably bought $1 million worth of your stuff over the last couple of years, Bosch. So that's shocking. Okay.
We will be getting more and more into it once we move into the new, because we've got a new facility coming.
Okay.
Once that opens, and that's by the end of the year.
Okay, no problem. Is Andrew at lunch, or where is Andrew right now?
Yes.
He's at lunch. Okay.
Yes,
I'll call back later then. Thank you.
Okay, you bet.
All right, bye. This fucking sucks.
People aren't going to believe it unless I show it to them.
Sensor. Oh. That's what Bosch is for, taking parts from one another to get the system up and running today. That's what Bosch is what? That's what Bosch is for. You know, if I'm doing this, it's a great client, and he's going to pay heavily. How much?
$5,000?
I'm going to charge him. There's no air conditioning in the shop.
I know.
Well, we have Kylie. Kylie's nice and cold in there.
Yeah, you could just go in there. No, I'm not being selfish.
Come on. What's your IG?
Give
you
drink, them my Venmo. Give them my
you,
Venmo.
Give them your Venmo. How about Cash App? You drink coffee?
I'm trying to make it. Oh, wait. I'm not being in video today, but Venmo me Kylie-Lazar. Venmo me. I'm not being in the
Why?
Video.
Why are they Venmoing me? What are you doing for them?
No, nothing. Just for knowing you.
Just for going? Uh-oh. This is Leonard.